Welcome back to the oneAPI channel. Images are noisy. It could happen due to multiple reasons, specifically ray-traced images, even after rendering thousands of rays, can sometimes be too noisy. The trick is, instead of going to full conversions and accumulate more and more rays that create more and more samples per pixel, which is very expensive, to use much lower sample count, here for example only 16, and then fix the noisy result using denoising algorithms in a fraction of the time. This is what Intel Open Image Denoise is all about. In previous videos, we've talked about the oneAPI components. We mentioned the multi-device, multi-vendor, and OpenSpec libraries that can now work on multiple devices, CPU, GPU, and others, what we call XPUs, and are arranged into toolkits. One of them is the oneAPI rendering toolkit, which includes the Open Image Denoise library. The Open Image Denoise library is a state-of-the-art denoiser. I'm talking about achieving the most accurate photorealistic images while dramatically reducing typical rendering time. The Open Image Denoise library can help you with multiple usages, could be preview or final frame, offline or interactive. So you could significantly reduce rendering time in ray tracing based rendering applications. The library is supplied with a set of pre-trained filter models. It basically can take several inputs for one frame. The required input is of course the noisy color image, but you can also use as an optional input the albedo and the normal passes to create even better denoised images. And if you like to optimize a filter for a specific renderer, specific sample count, content type, or scene, it is possible to retrain the model with your specific dataset and parameters. Google Open Image Denoise and go to the GitHub page. All the information you need is here. Scroll down to the training section. You can find here the description for all the scripts you need to pre-process a dataset, to train, to infer, and even to visualize using TensorBoard. These are the dataset requirements. Here you can find the weights for the neural networks. They are all built on top of oneAPI, oneDNN library, of course. And under training, you can find all the scripts you need to get started, the model itself, and more. You can use the Open Image Denoise on Windows, Linux, and macOS, on Intel CPUs and soon GPUs, and on Apple M1. It is highly accelerated with the latest AVX instruction, and it can run on anything from laptops to workstation to compute nodes in HPC systems, and for many systems, the performance is sufficient even for interactive ray tracing. A simple but flexible C or C++ API ensures that the library can be easily integrated into your application. And the code and the spec are open, great performance, full functionality, flexibility, scalability, and openness. Many vendors are already using the Image Denoise library in their platforms for creating, gaming, scientific, and product design tools and more. Blender, Chaos Groups, Corona, and V-Ray, Cinema 4D, Unity are just few examples. So when you're using these software suites, you're already enjoying the benefits of the Open Image Denoise. The results are impressive and look very close to the ground truth with a fraction of the compute required. Make sure Open Image Denoise is included and enabled in your renderer. Or you could use a denoiser yourself. The easiest way to see the Image Denoise library in action is probably using the Intel DevCloud. Just Google Intel DevCloud. Registration and setting up take minutes. This is my noisy HDR image, and this is the corresponding albedo and normal images. I'm connecting to the Intel DevCloud, and I'm using SCP on Cygwin to copy my files to the DevCloud. And the files are here. Now I'm asking for a specific machine for the rendering toolkit. You can find the instructions in the DevCloud page. My files are here. I'm preparing an output file, and now I'll run the Open Image Denoise, latest bean, the Denoise demo. It is all installed and ready to run. My input is the HDR image only, and my output, and running. The code for this sample is in the GitHub page. Navigate to apps And here is a C++ code. All the parameters, a great way to get started. And I'll copy the output back from my dev cloud to my computer. This is our original noisy image. And this is the image after denoising. This looks like magic. I'll run the same demo, but now I'll also feed it the albedo and the normal images. I'll copy the results, and I hope you can see on the left side where I use a normal and albedo that there are more details. Look at the face of the character. The image is smoother in the right places and sharper where needed. Pretty cool. Open Image Denoise. High performance, high quality denoising filter for images rendered with ray tracing. Use them, retrain them, enjoy them. Thank you.